Hi, in this video we will configure a BLDC motor to work with a motion controller. This is a MC5010, but this guide is also valid for 5004 and 5005. My name is Christer Larsson and I'm a motor application engineer on Compotech provider. The motion controller is configured easily with a software called Motion Manager. You find it on FAULHABER's website. Click on Products, Drive Electronic, Motion Controller, and select the motion controller you have. On this page, you find under More Downloads. Scroll down, and there you have Motion Manager. We're clicking on the download link. Scroll down on this page as well, which describes a bit on the Motion Manager, and select the latest version. This version, version 6, is compatible with Windows 7 and later versions, such as Windows 8 and 10. If you have an older type operating system, like Windows XP, you need to use the Motion Manager version 5. Alright, now we got it installed. Next step is to connect the motion controller to our computer and the motor to the motion controller. On this side you will find the interfaces. On the other side, the connections to the motor. Here you find a label with the part number and serial information. We will connect the motion controller to our computer using a USB cable. Plug in the USB cable in the motion controller and find an empty port on your computer. Alright. The power supply is connected using pluggable terminal blocks. A list of part numbers for mating blocks are found in the description for the video. For the motor, there are ready-made cables available, plug and play. Please feel free to contact Compotech to select the right cable for your combination of motor and controller. The motor faces are connected in the outlet motor M1. The Hall effect sensors are connected into sensor M2. There is also a grounding wire, which should be connected to the controller like this. Alright, now we got the motor cable connected to the motion controller, then it's just to plug in the motor into the motor cable, like this. Now there's just one thing remaining, and that is connecting the motion controller to power. And we see from the status LEDs that it starts up. At the same time, we can see how the drivers for the motion controller are installing into the computer. With that in place, we click on Establish Connection, choose the USB port, and search. Alright, next step is to select motor. We have a brushless DC motor, so we're going for that one. It's the type 3268, you find it a bit down in the list, and select the type. Once ready, we click on Next. In this dialog, we are selecting what sensor systems our motor has. In this example, it has a 3-channel Hall sensor, but no optical encoder. In the dialog following, we can select what sensor system to use for commutation, velocity, and position. Well, we only have the Hall effect, but if the motor you are using has optical encoders, you might want to use that for position and velocity. During operation, when the motor is going from a high RPM down on a lower RPM, it will work as a generator and feed back power into your power supply. In this dialog, you can limit the amount of power that will be fed back. The default value of 150% works fine for my power supply, so I just go ahead and click on Next. Alright, then all the settings are done and we're ready to transfer the configuration down to our motion controller. We're doing that and clicking on Next. Now the motion controller wants to calibrate the Hall effect sensors. In order to do that, it needs to power up the motor and make it rotate. Therefore, we get a question if the drive is idle and it can rotate freely. We click on yes. I'm marking the motor shaft so you can see how it behaves during calibration. I also put my hand on the motor to prevent it from moving around. It does the calibration. And it seemed to be working out just fine. So I'm clicking on finished. I'm saving that to the controller. Now, to run this little program, it's an example program, we need to manually set the operation mode. You find that under drive function, operation mode, and cyclic sync velocity mode. Select that, click on send, and then close this window. Now I have copied the program onto my clipboard. That program code should be pasted into the editor. You find editor under view, editor, and then we just erase the stuff which is here and paste in a program code. Now, what this simple program does is it initializes the motor, it spins the motor clockwise slowly for 5 seconds, and then kind of rapid rotation backwards for 5 seconds. So with this in place, we download that to the motion controller, save it as program number 1, and then we're ready to run the program. Just press the play button up in the left hand corner. Let's see now, 5 seconds wait time, 5 seconds slow rotation clockwise, and then 5 seconds with high speed anti-clockwise rotation. Well, seems to be working out just fine. In this video tutorial, we have been installing Motion Manager 6 on a PC. We have connected a FAULHABER Motion Controller 5010 to the PC, added and configured a BLDC motor type 3268. We have pasted a program into the editor, downloaded it into the controller, and made a test run. For more information, please check out Compotech website on compotech.se and switch to the English version. Alright, here you'll find our product offerings as well as our tech blog. Thank you for watching the tutorial!